And horror statue? Not really, just the Gothic dark side. Stay with me, and after the intro, we are going to learn more about the Gothic sculpture. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Exploring Art. This is Alessandro. Today we are going to discover more about Gothic art, in particular the role of the sculpture. In the previous video, we learned how the Gothic style developed from architecture, and the sculpture was not really following that evolution. The Gothic sculpture, in fact, is a heterogeneous group of works of art that differ on their purposes and styles. We have, in fact, portable sculptures, monumental sculptures, decorative sculptures, tomb effigies, with many variants based on the region. Here today I want to focus on the monumental sculpture because of its connection with the architecture and the communication role in the society. Why that? Well, because we cannot forget that we are during one of the most complicated historical moments, the Middle Ages. A period of time full of uncertainties, fears, and hopes that affected the society that was living on a difficult balance between a material temporal level and a mystical unknown one. We can find these elements in the sculptures of the Chartres Cathedral's west facade. Located in Chartres, France, about 80 kilometers or 50 miles southwest of Paris, it's one of the most beautiful Gothic cathedrals. The sculptures on the three west portals, the church's facade, are some of the finest and oldest examples of Gothic monumental sculptures. Each portal, highly decorated and made between 1145-1155, focuses on a different moment of Christ's role in the world. On the left is Ascension, or Second Coming, in the center, Christ in Majesty, and on the right, the Nativity. The left portal is the most enigmatic one, since we still don't know exactly if the tympanum's scene depicts Christ's Ascension or the Second Coming of Christ. That's why I picked it. Just kidding, I chose it because there are many interesting elements to talk about. We can see that Jesus stands on a cloud, apparently supported by two angels. And they seem to be in a weird posture, but that's because the artist wanted to fill the space on Jesus' sides in the best possible way. Other four angels below them are shouting to 10 mysterious figures in the lintel who are looking up like trying to understand in what kind of trouble they are. The archivals contain a combination of zodiac signs and labors of the month. Probably you're wondering why they are on a church's facade, but actually this is common in many Gothic portals and it represents how the nature cycles depend on the seasons. However, there is also a deeper mystic meaning. The labors of the months have an important significance because they depict 12 rural activities that commonly took place in specific months of the year. In a society based on agriculture, that have a vital didactic meaning. But the connection with astrology gives us the idea of how human affairs and terrestrial events were considered a consequence of not well-known mystical events. Starting from the bottom left, we can see some combinations, like Cancer, this kind of scary monster more than a crab, and a harvest, probably wheat, or at their side, Aries with a human figure pruning a tree. On the right side, at the bottom, it's visible Capricorn, and below it the only scene depicting an indoor moment, since it's December and there are no jobs in the fields. And on the same side, the attention goes to the Scorpio that is above a man plowing, we are in October. The Scorpio is well defined in every detail. Look in particular at the decorations on the vertebral column that continue until the end of the tail that has the shape of a dragon head or something similar. The Scorpio's face is hard to understand if it's more of a human or animal. There is a grimace, but it's still very detailed and there are decorations even on the tongue. We are far from the realism that we can see in the other figures, and there is a clear attempt of making it scary. We are looking at one of the first examples of evil creatures that are present in the Gothic cathedrals and made this style so enigmatic and evocative.
From our point of view, it could seem really weird, the combination of astrology, religion, and monsters, but it can give us the idea of how Middle Ages were a very difficult time based on thin balances. However, it's exactly from these thin balances that our ancestors came out with brilliant solutions that we are going to explore during our journey. And about that, in the next episode, I will talk about Gothic windows, so don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you soon.